were married 21 years ago by the justice of the peace. Was it wrong? Yes? It was wrong for you to do that. Marriage belongs in the house of God. But being that you are married, here's when you're really married. You're married when you vow one to the other. When you promise one another that you'll take one another, the justice of peace could give you license. That's legal terms of living together as husband and wife without being common law husband and wife. But when you promise this girl, and this, you promise that man that you'll live true to him and you take him to be your husband, you're married then. Remember I explained that last week, I believe it was, see? When you promise her, see? Even in the old Bible, if a man was betrothed to a maid, and you know the laws on that, it was just the same as an adultery. It certainly was. When he promised, that was it. The question is... Now, say you got married by a magistrate, you should have been married by the church, by the minister. That's a decent thing to do for a Christian. But being that you have already made that promise and vow and been married 21 years ago, I think it's all right. You say, well, the question might be, should I come and be married again? If you wish to. Don't have nothing in your mind that bothers your faith, because if anything's there, you can't go no further than right there. You stop right there when that question mark comes. That's where you end. Right there. But I, for me, it would be all right. Sure, they're married. As long as they take that vow, they're married. It's like a boy. If a boy promises a girl to marry her under good faith, he's obligated to that girl. He's just as good as married her. The only thing the law does is give you a bill of rights to live together, to keep and be common law husband and wife. But when a man tells a woman, I will marry you, honey, I'll take you for my wife, when you take, he's married. Your vow is sacred. That's what marries you anyhow. It's not no preacher can marry you, no magistrate or nothing else. It's your own vow to God and to this man. When you promise, you are married. Looky. But if they cannot contain, let them marry, for it is better to marry than to burn. All right. Espousing in the East was the same as marriage, as betrothal. As soon as they were espoused, they were married. When that sacred vow between them was taken, read Deuteronomy 22:23, and you'll find out that when this woman and man agreed to be married, yet they did not take the vows for months later, if they even broke that vow, they were guilty of adultery. That's right. When they was espoused, they were just the same as marriage. The law had not given rights to live together as husband and wife yet, but before God, when they promised one another, their words were sealed in God's kingdom. And to break that was just committing adultery. And now, Joseph was espoused to Mary.